Welcome back. You know, there are simple things that you can do right now to boost your immune system. And here with more on that is naturopathic physician, Dr. Theresa Ramsey. This is great because a lot of people feel like when something's coming on, this is a way to kind of get it before it gets
too bad,
right?
Exactly.
Okay.
If we get ahead of it, then we don't have to get so sick and get on antibiotics. So
right. What are some of the things we could do?
Okay, there's something that I'd like to start with because it's so effective for children and adults, and this is called a nasal lavage. Have you heard of that before?
Yes, I have, and it's funny because I'm hearing more and more about it.
Right.
And that is basically a squirt in...
Yeah, and I'll show you. It's so easy. They've made it easier and easier, but you fill it with water, and there's a saline solution for children. This is for the kid's size. This is the adult size.
Okay.
This fits in the nostril. I'm just going to show you just over here. You just squeeze it, and it goes up into the sinus cavities.
Right.
So it's more... comprehensive than just using nasal sprays because it cleans out your whole sinus cavity.
Now, does it come out the other side?
It does.
I saw that on Grey's Anatomy. They were doing it to that guy.
It does.
So you
hold
one side
there, it's going to come out.
It comes out.
Yep.
Now, what would you take that for
so
sinus?
In the Asian culture, they use it for hygiene morning and night when they brush their teeth.
Wow.
Just to cleanse their sinuses because we live in such a toxic world. What we tend to do in the States is use it when we start to get infections or we start to have allergies. So the other thing is there's an antibiotic, instead of taking an oral antibiotic for a sinus infection, that's a liquid you can put in here and just treat your sinuses so you're not exposed to the antibiotic to your whole body.
Interesting.
So it's wonderful. You could put hydrogen peroxide in there as well.
Would you use the whole bottle for one treatment?
Yes, and then after they're done, the kids like to play with it in their bathtub. So it's one way to get them to use it because then they get to use it as a
see,
water
toy.
See,
that's the part, Dr. Ramsey, getting my kids to let me do this to them. I've tried that before and it didn't go well. So
you need to
really play it up big. Come on, kids, it's going to be fun. You can watch it squirt out the other side. And they're like, no!
Yeah. Maybe you can demonstrate. You can get these at any local grocery store or Walgreens, etc.
All right. I saw that on Grey's Anatomy. I remember
that episode.
Okay.
There's some great teas you could buy at any grocery store now. Traditional Medicinal makes them. One for the respiratory tract, which really, I mean, if you're going to take a nice hot bath and drink a nice cup of tea for your lungs, for your throat.
So you do believe in the good old remedy
of
good tea.
That's right. If you want to make your own, I made one. I don't know if you want to taste it or not.
But after that cod liver oil, I don't trust you.
This is basically a cleansing tea, and everything in here is just, I just made the tea last night, strained it, and it makes the tea. And you can sip on this tea. It tastes like, you know, vegetable broth.
What's in there?
But it's basically parsley, which is a blood cleanser.
Okay.
It's got potatoes, which is actually another blood cleanser. It has a lot of potassium in there that our immune system needs. Some zucchini and some green beans. That's all it is. That's all it is. The recipe is on the website if people want to download it.
Well, that sounds like you said, like chicken broth, which is always... Tastes good. Vegetable broth.
Right.
Okay.
So you can make your own at home. You could buy it at the store and just steep it.
Okay.
And then go into a hot bath with Epsom salts.
Mm-hmm.
Epsom salts are basically magnesium, and you have to be careful. Anybody with a heart condition needs to be careful because it dilates your vessels. And I put 3 to 4 large containers in a bath when I'm feeling sick. I mean, that's a lot of Epsom salts.
So that's just when you're feeling lousy? Because I always do this for muscle ache.
You can do it to just relax. You can do it to help recover from muscle strain. Absolutely. Because what magnesium does is dilate your vessels, so all of the nutrition to your cells is enhanced. And if you put a lot in, you could be very kind of lightheaded when you stand up, so be very careful if you have a heart condition. Maybe just use one bag. Make sure someone's there when you stand up because you look red from head to toe.
Gotcha.
So it's wonderful to dilate your vessels.
What else do you have over here?
This is something called zinc tally. People think of taking zinc for their throat, right? If they have strep throat or sore throat. This is a way to test your immune system to see if you have a strong immune system or not. Do you want to test yours?
Sure.
So all you do
I bet it's not strong.
Well, depending on the taste, will tell me how strong your immune system is.
So I'm going to taste
this. So put that in your mouth.
What did you mix it with?
Nothing. It's straight
just
zinc.
Pure zinc.
So hold it in your mouth, swish it around for a little bit. I'm going to ask you what it tastes like and then explain to you what that means based on what it tastes like.
Mm-hmm.
If it's not good, swallow it. Go ahead, swallow it now. So describe what it tasted like to you.
Nothing.
Okay.
Almost like water.
So if it tastes like water, that means your zinc levels are low. If it tastes like metal and you want to spit it out, like almost like your cavities are touching each other, you have enough zinc in your body. Zinc prevents bacteria, viruses, parasites from adhering to our tissue. That's why we take zinc supplements.
Okay.
That's why we take zinc lozenges for sore throat. So you could take a tablespoon every day. When it starts tasting really strong, then you know your zinc levels are high.
See, I'm not surprised. I know I have a low immune system. So that's interesting.
Yeah.
It's a little tester.
Because
I still don't really taste anything. And maybe a little bit of salt, but not much.
And the first sign sometimes is just a little dryness, a little dry aftertaste.
Yeah.
But you want it to taste like metal that you want to spit out. Then you know you have enough zinc.
Wow. So what? So just keep taking this?
Tablespoon a day until you taste it.
And that'll boost my zinc.
Right. And then just stay on a multiple vitamin that has zinc in it, and you should be fine.
Oh,
If you get sick, take a little extra zinc as well.
I love all this experimentation stuff. That's pretty cool.
Okay. I know. For the kids in the bath, if you want to smell how beautiful this is, when they're starting to feel sick, that just, again, opens their sinuses. You just put it right in the bathtub. It's safe for mucous membranes.
You know, it's funny when you come, and I don't mean any disrespect, but all this stuff is like what my mother and my grandmother did.
I know.
And it's like the good old-fashioned ways seem to be strong and true.
They really are. They haven't.
Now, this is what I did this morning, so I must be doing something right. It looks like oatmeal and...
Yeah, this is basically a recipe called the Immune Support Breakfast that's been around for years. It was originally designed to treat asthma patients. Okay. The reason is what the ingredients are in there. And again, for free, people can go to my website and just copy the recipe. One of the main ingredients is milk thistle, which you may have heard of.
Milk thistle?
Milk thistle. A lot of patients that have liver disease, cirrhosis, hepatitis will use milk thistle as a medicine in food. It just helps our lymphatic system drain.
Okay.
It has a lecithin in there, which comes from soy, which every cell membrane needs to be healthy. It's got nuts in there that has a good essential fatty acids, raw nuts, so cashews, pumpkin seeds,
sounds
walnuts.
Sounds good, actually. Yep. Now, is this what you eat when you feel sick, or is this what you should eat all the time to prevent getting sick?
It's good to eat all the time in rotation, you know, not to eat something every single day.
Okay.
So I mix it up to show you what it looks like, because what happens is it absorbs the milk alternative. I don't like to promote dairy when we're congested, obviously.
Right.
And so it kind of gets mushy.
Yeah.
And you can add your fruit in there if you'd like it to be a little bit sweeter. It's great fiber. Patients really love this because it gives them a nice bulk, you know, every day to get your fiber. So very good for the immune system. And then if you want to, if you're having sinus issues, this is good to do a sinus inhalation. You just boil water, put a few drops in, put a towel over your head. Breathe in the oils, and it opens your sinus cavity.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
We need to do this again come like November, when everyone starts feeling lousy again.
Right.
But thank you. Good stuff. What my grandmother would have recommended as well. Thank you, Dr. Ramsey, and my mom. So thumbs up.
Thank you
again. All right, and if you would like to contact Dr. Ramsey, or if you want more information about what we talked about, you could go to our hotline or go to our website. We've got all of your information there. Mm-hmm. So see, tried and true stuff. Thank you very much. All right.
Thank you.
Coming up next, Chef Chuck Wiley is in the kitchen making.